Hey everyone, today we're really gonna dive into the basics of animation inside of Storyline 360. And really, when you're working with e-learning developments, how to get started with animations, the different types of shortcuts that you can do, all with animations inside of Storyline. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, my name is Jeff Batt, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts covering anything learning development related. You can also download free templates and check out full courses on any e-learning development tool. So animation is a big part of e-learning. And really, when you're thinking about animation, you need to think about what purpose does the animation serve? Does it enhance the story? Does it add to the story? Does it allow you to control the content of what's visible at certain points to the learner so they're not overloaded with content as well? Animation is a big part of that. And I'm gonna show you how to get started with the animation and some things to keep in mind when you're working with animation inside of Storyline. Now, beyond that, I have a whole series of how to get started with custom animation and using some JavaScript snippets to add additional animations that you can that you can't do out of the box with Storyline, because right now, animation is pretty limited as far as what you can do inside of Storyline. So I'll show you all the different options that you can do out of the box, but just know that we can even go further and check out those videos to explore more on that. So let's go ahead and dive into Storyline. And you can see right now, I just have some basic pages, my cooking 101 course that we learned about in my Storyline course. And right now, I just wanna go ahead and add some animations to kind of bring this one to life. So the first two pages, I do not have any audio. So let's go ahead and do some basic animations to this. Notice that I have this rectangle and then I have the text actually on top of that rectangle. One of the nice things about rectangles and shapes is I can actually add text to the rectangle. And if you do that, it's one object rather than two objects. And that is really when you're working with animation, sometimes that's nice because I can animate the entire object in rather than having to animate in the shape and then the text. It's just one object, which we'll learn about that in the next slide. But if you're working with two different items, what we can do first of all is go ahead and animate this in. Now we have an entrance animation, so I can select this drop down box and click on fade if I want this to just fade in. And then we have an exit animation. If I don't want this to fade out or animate out, I don't need to select anything there. I just go ahead and select the fade in. Now, even though this is fade in, there's some things that I can adjust in this. So the first thing I can adjust is the duration. Now you can adjust the duration in two different ways. You can adjust it by actually giving it a specific duration up here on the top, or you can come down to the timeline and you can click and drag this little yellow square, and that will adjust the duration as well. Notice how I stretch it out, and it will actually adjust the duration up on top. If I want this to be a little bit shorter, I can go ahead and adjust the duration down there, which is a nice visual way for me to be able to adjust how long this animation happens. That's not all that I can do with the animations. If I come to Effect Options, I can have this also animate in from the left or animate in from the right or bottom or whatever direction that I want. A rule of thumb is do not, if you have other objects that are kind of on the stage, do not animate over those objects. I see often where I have like a people person here, here's the stage, and so I have a people person here, and the text is supposed to go here, but the text goes across the person over and then over to this location. If the text is gonna end up here, have the text come in from this side and not go across anything else. I don't know why that bugs me. It just bugs me when I see that kind of thing happen, so stop it. I'm just kidding. If you really wanna do it, you can do it, but it's just you're crossing over things and it makes more sense to have it come over from this side. That is my first thing. Notice these other things that I can do, like bounce and grow and fly in and other things. I don't know if this comes from like when I used to do wedding videos back in the day, but I mean, you can always tell the amateur person when you were doing wedding videos of like the person that did all these effects. And the only way that you can get away with these types of effects, in my opinion, is if you're Star Wars, because those effects just work. But if you're not Star Wars, you're not Lucasfilm, I would stay away from those and just keep it basic of either just cut or fade or move and just kind of that basic concept there. Or in some cases, you may want to do bounce. If you have like a little basketball bounce in or something, you can do that. All right, so we're gonna stick with fade for now. And for this one, we're just gonna have it fade in. But for this one, let's go ahead and have it fade and move. So I'm gonna come in here, and if I click on fly in, you may think, oh, fly in will have it come in, but it's not gonna fade at the same time. So the better thing to do, instead of just have it fly in, if you wanna have it fade and fly in, is to click fade and then have it fly in from the left or the right or something like that. So now just by doing that, watch what happens is the black bar will fade in and then the text will fade in at the same time. Now the black bar is not sliding, but because the text is sliding, it kind of makes it look like both are sliding in, which is cool. I may want that. But we can also stagger this along our timeline. So we first of all adjust the animations and add the animations, and then we adjust the timeline down at the bottom. So if I want the text to delay a little bit, what I could do is click and drag the edge here and move that past the animation. So let's let the black bar fade in first and then have our text kind of fade in after that, or fade in move. So I'm gonna go ahead and preview this again. And so you can see the bar comes in and then our text comes in right after that. Staggering along the timeline is the next key. And especially if you're working with audio, if you have some audio, then you're gonna wanna time it to the audio. But let's go to the next page. Before we get into the audio, let's go to the next page and talk about that. Right here, what we have is our text that's actually part of the shape. So in this case, it kind of simplifies our animation. Instead of having to animate in those separately, what I can do here is just select that shape here, and then I can add the animation. Now I want this to also fade in from the, or fade in, but also move from the right. And so now what will happen here is you'll see the image and then you'll see the object kind of slide in right there. So you can see here, that's a nice little animation. And because there's no audio, I can just have it happen right away. Or if I want to delay this a little bit, I can go ahead and delay this a little bit. That way they get the full image before the text actually fades in, and they can process that for a second and then have that text kind of fade in right after that. So the timing, adding the animation, adding the duration of that animation, and then adding the, or adjusting the timeline down at the bottom is really key when you're working with animations inside of Storyline. Now let's go and do a little bit more complex animation because we have some audio on this one, and I'm gonna stretch this out a little bit more. And this one I think is a good minute, yeah, almost a minute of audio here. Now what I wanna do is have these objects kind of fade in and fade out along the timeline. So to do this, there's a couple of things. I can add the fade in, I can add the fade out, but I wanna just, I always like to approach it first of all of getting the right timing. And so I'm gonna come in and say, okay, this is where I want arrow one to come in, and then this is where I want arrow two to come in. Let's say down here a little bit longer. And then let's say I want arrow one to go away after a certain time. But if I scroll down to the edge, this little triangle right here lets me know that it's gonna be visible until the end of the timeline. So I can change that in a couple different ways. I can click and I can drag and I can move that over if I wanted to. And I'll do that for this one. So I can click and drag and adjust that. That could become a pain if I had to do that every single time. So I'm gonna go ahead and do something else. I'm gonna right click here and then I'm gonna go to timing, and then I can say uncheck where it says show until the end, and then I'm going to adjust this to something like, let's do like 5 seconds here. So this is in seconds. So I'm gonna adjust this, oh, that's the start time. I'm gonna adjust this to be like the end time. Maybe let's do like 26 seconds here and then click on close. Oh, it's gonna be 26 seconds long. So even though it starts at 19, it's gonna continue. Let's actually change that. I'm gonna have this be 10 seconds long. So now you can see that it brings it in. So we can do that. We can also, if you're bringing it over, there is a shortcut key. I'm not remembering what the shortcut key is. If you have to drag it over to like skip it to the beginning, you could look that up. But you can see here, this is how we start to adjust things along our timeline. Now, if I come in here and add like a fade in, so I'm gonna do a fade in, and let's have this move over. It's gonna be pointing right here. So let's have it move over from the left. And then we'll have it fade out. So now this is one opportunity where I have to fade something out because it's not gonna be visible the entire time and I don't want it to just go away. I wanna fade it out. So I'm gonna do the same thing here. But one of the nice things about animations is there's something called an animation painter. Now, animation painter allows me to take an animation that I've already created and apply it to another object. So what I can do, and this is similar to the format painter. If you've used the format painter inside of Storyline, this is very similar. First of all, select the one that has the right animation, then go up and click on Animation Painter, and then all you have to do is select the object on the stage that you want to have that same animation applied to. That way I don't have to recreate of selecting the drop-down boxes and have it slide in from the left and have it fade out. It's just easier for me to copy that same animation into this other animation. Now let's preview this, because what's going to happen is these arrows are just going to show up at different times. So I'm going to preview this, but I'm also going to mute my audio here. So the arrows are going to show up at a certain point here. So you can see there's arrow one. It's going to go ahead and animate out here in a couple seconds. So you can see there's the fade out, and then there's my fade in. So it allows me to apply these animations. Now there's a couple other things that I can do. Is I can also animate in my text. This is also, I don't know why I'm just kind of explaining all these pet peeves of mine, but there's another pet peeve of having too much text before the audio gets to that point. Of basically you have so much text, and to me it's distracting because I'm looking at all the text, but I'm trying to listen, but I'm also trying to see what all the text is. And so to me, I like to be able to animate and only show the text that's relevant to that audio. If you want text, sometimes we don't need the text. Sometimes you can just have an image or some icon or something like that. But if you want to have text there, there is the ability to animate by paragraph. So I could come in here, and let's say that we want to have this fade in, and we're going to fade it in from the right so we're not overlapping the image. And I'm going to have this come in from the right here. But I only want to do this per line. So it'd be like the title, the first paragraph, and then the second paragraph. To do that, you come back into Effect Options here, and instead of one object at a time, you can click on By Paragraph. Then what it does is it creates this little twirl down for us that we can now come in here and adjust the title. We can adjust the first paragraph here. We can adjust the second paragraph, and we can kind of align those out. So this allows us to kind of animate the separate text and only have what's actually being talked about visible at that time, which I think is a much better approach. And instead of overloading them with information, you just provide the information when it's relevant, basically. But there's a better way to actually animate this too. So what I can do, because right now I don't really know what the audio is. So what I can do is I can click play and I can listen to the audio. As the animation starts to play, I just hit the letter C. So if I hit the letter C, what it will do is it'll create a cue point for me. So I'm going to click on play again. And at important parts, I'm going to go ahead and hit the cue point.
Fat backhand dewy brisket, tri-tip rump, chicken shoulder strip steak, ground round.
So as I start to listen to it, I just basically hit a cue point at the important parts. This will help speed up your animation, because now watch what happens. So what I can do is right click and then go to align to cue point and just do cue point one. Then I can go to the second paragraph, align to cue point two. Then I can do the third paragraph, align to cue point, and then cue point three. That is a lot more simple than having to listen, pause, move it over, listen again, pause, move it over. You just hit the letter C as you're starting to play, and then you just right click and align it to cue point. Now I could still adjust these cue points afterwards, and then I just have to right click and align it to cue point again to be able to animate that, or I could just click and drag if needed. So just a quicker way to be able to animate along the timeline there. I could come in and do the format painter and add the fade in if I wanted to, or I could even come up to my image and I can have a fade in at a cue point as well. And you can go ahead and have that all animate in at separate times. Now there are other things you can do. We've talked about animations, the entrance animation. We've talked about the exit animation. There are also motion paths that allow you to animate from one point to another point. I'm going to do a separate video completely on Motion Pass because you can do a lot with Motion Pass. You can have several different Motion Pass. You can have it relative to a certain object. And so it will require a lot more in-depth kind of explanation of what Motion Pass are and how to take advantage of Motion Pass. So if you want to see that and you like my video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button and subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That helps my channel, helps with the algorithm, allows me to continue to grow, to produce these videos for you to help you with your e-learning development. Also, if you want to see more videos, if you have specific requests, go ahead and head on over to my YouTube channel and make a comment. What do you want to see? If you do want to see the animation or the motion pass, go ahead and comment and say, hey, I want to see the motion pass and really dive into that. But hopefully this has been helpful for you and you're able to start applying this, and hopefully you picked up a few things here and there, even if you've done a little bit with animations and you've been able to improve how you do animations as well. That's all I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.